It's time for our daily devotion, daily abiding in Jesus Christ. In the book of John chapter 15 verse 7, if ye abide in me, and my words abide in you, ye shall ask what ye will, and it shall be done unto you. A daily devotional ministry project of Christo Doginogaga from passages taken from the Holy Scriptures with quotations from the Spirit of Prophecy by Ellen G. White. Daily abiding in Jesus Christ.
June 24, 2020. Romans 14 verse 16 to 19. For the kingdom of God is not meat and drink, but righteousness and peace and joy in the Holy Ghost. For he that in these things serveth Christ is acceptable to God, and approved of men. Let us therefore follow after the things which make for peace, and things wherewith one may edify another.
Quotation from the Spirit of Prophecy. Jesus himself never purchased peace by compromise. His heart overflowed with love for the whole human race, but he was never indulgent to their sins. He was too much their friend to remain silent while they were pursuing a course that would ruin their souls, the souls he had purchased with his own blood. He labored that man should be true to himself, true to his higher and eternal interest. The servants of Christ are called to the same work, and they should beware lest, in seeking to prevent discord, they surrender the truth. They are to follow after the things which make for peace, Romans 14 verse 19. But real peace can never be secured by compromising principle. And no man can be true to principle without exciting opposition. A Christianity that is spiritual will be opposed by the children of disobedience. Those who are true to God need not fear the power of men nor the enmity of Satan. In Christ their eternal life is secure. Their only fear should be lest they surrender the truth, and thus betray the trust with which God has honored them. By Ellen White, Desire of Ages, page 356.
Our prayer for today. Dear God, our Father in heaven, in humility, we approach your holy presence. Thank you for loving us by sending your only begotten Son to be one with us and finally died at the cross in our place, died the eternal death for us. Through him, we have received the free gift of salvation. We pray for the gift of righteousness from you. Thank you for answering our prayer, for we ask in the name of Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior. Amen.